America, one of America's top, one of the world's top heavyweights, Jarrell Big Baby Miller. How you doing today, Vivid?
Chilling, man. Having fun, but we do what we do best, man.
Got you. Tell me about you. I remember seeing you in Mayweather Boxing Club a couple years ago. Noticed your skill. Things have taken off since then. Yeah. Give me the latest. Update me in fans.
I fought about a month ago in the Barclays Center. Was able to get TV because of Jarrell Watson's contract. But either way, it's still good exposure to fight on short notice in my hometown. Showed up people wide of what they've been missing. So hopefully to come back November 4th, co-main event on a Deontay Wilder undercard on Showtime. Looking for an opponent. Hopefully Dylan White will put his money where his mouth is and take his mouth off Eddie Hearn's pacifier and get to work.
Tell me about Dylan White. Why do you mention his name?
Because Dylan White's been very vocal. I mean, all due respect, my two favorite heavyweights in the division right now are Tyson Fury, even though he's out of it right now, and Dylan White. I respect Dylan White because he comes, he talks smack, he's a real guy, he's a real fighter. I actually like him. I still want to break his face, so that's all it is. So it's going to be a good fight. I think it'll be good for heavyweight division. I know he needs a good fight under his belt to come back, and I need somebody who can bring it.
Tell me about your last performance, a kind of nice step up and just coming through with the win.
Yeah, man, from 1 to 10, I gave my performance a 5. It was a short notice fight for me and my team because it was a kind of explosion we needed. We needed a fight in Brooklyn, and that's what I wanted. You know, I could have waited a little longer and fight September or fight mid-August, but I said, nah, man, I got to fight in Brooklyn, man. It's my hometown. It's a good undercard, and I took advantage of him.
What do you think of Deontay Wilder, his return? I heard he might be facing Stavern. I'm not sure. What do you think?
I mean, he should have been forced to Stavern at least about a year ago, give his mandatory rematch that he was supposed to get. I'm not a big fan. You know how I feel about Deontay Wilder. At the end of the day, man, these guys, they talk and talk, but don't really back it up. He's fighting. Jarrell Washington wasn't even in the top 10 or 15 rankings when he fought Jarrell Washington, and he got in the WBC rankings like 5 days before they fought for the WBC title. You know what I mean? So that'll tell you how they maneuver things around. But he was still in the rankings, and they kind of called me out. So I said, shit, he called me out. He thought I was going to be out of shape, but you can't see that. For 300-pound behemoth, I outran the rip guy.
What do you think of Anthony Joshua's victory over Klitschko, as well as Klitschko's retirement?
I mean, it's that Vladimir Klitschko retired. I mean, truthfully, Anthony Joshua took away a dream of mine, was knocking out Vladimir Klitschko. Being strong with Vladimir when I was 20-21, winning 2 pro fights, and wobbling him a couple times. So that was one of my dreams, so hands down, Anthony Joshua's on my hit list. I'm going to break him in freaking half.
Why do you say that? What makes you so confident?
Because I know what I bring to the table. I know what my heart is made of. I know what I'm mentally made of. I know what I'm physically made of. You know what I mean? Protein shakes don't make a champion. Period. You know what I mean? I don't care what he's going to drink. What ain't going to help
him. What do you think of him as a fighter? Does anything stand out?
I mean, he's a fighter. He's a good fighter. You know what I mean? They gave him the Olympics in London in his hometown.
Yeah.
I mean, 2 of the fights he hand down lost. Dylan White seen it, said it. Tyson Fury said it, seen it. A bunch of media guy from UK said it. Yeah, that's the fights he lost, but they gave it to him in his hometown. So that gold medal that he got is really a copper medal to me.
You know
what I mean? So like I said before, I know what he bring to the table. I know what I bring to the table. And muscles don't make fights.
Tell me about your upbringing in boxing. Where you're from? How you got into this game?
Originally born in Bedford Stuyvesant, in Brooklyn. Grew up in Belize, Central America. You know, my family is very diverse. My father hails Dominican descent. I have cousins Guatemalan and Mexican. You know what I mean? So when people were saying Gerard is the black Mexican, I'm actually a black Mexican my damn self. So like, it's rough, man. I grew up in the house of 17 siblings. You know what I mean? It's a fight every day, but I learned how to, you know, get past that, and it's be who I am today.
Going to boxing, what temptations does that take you away from? A lot of you people, they're in the streets, and boxing changed things. How did it change you?
I mean, boxing has kind of gave me something to motivate me to do something better, you know what I mean? I played football for a little while, but I wasn't into really much of the team sports. Kept me away from the streets. This kind of kept me in a narrow path, give my mind something else to focus on, you know what I mean?
Floyd Mayweather, Conor McGregor, what are your thoughts?
Floyd stops him in the 7th round. You know, one of the best in MMA going to fight the best in boxing. On paper and statistics, the boxer going to win in a boxing ring.
Gotcha. Do you follow the whole sport, like Golovkin, Canelo? What are your thoughts?
Yeah, most definitely.
How about Anthony Johnson? He's an opponent.
Yeah. You need an opponent. You need a knockout. That's how I see it. I got my money on Triple G. I feel Triple G fought a better opposition, even though Canelo fought Floyd. He lost and got shut out. So, I mean, listen. Triple G can't box a little bit. Canelo can't box. But Triple G's the bigger guy, so I'm gonna go with the bigger guy, tougher opponent.
Are you how? Where does your training camp stay now? And how often do you travel? Where are you at? Just
I get bored very easy, so I like to go. I like to go to people's backyards. So I go to Florida, of course, the Vernon. Sometimes I go to other places, and I just kick butt. So it all depends.
How can people reach out and follow you?
Follow me, Big Baby Miller Instagram, Big Baby Miller Twitter, Big Baby Facebook.
Best of luck to you.
Best of luck.